Welcome back to Hammer Homage, where I'm taking you through a catalogue of Hammer Productions films. Today's film marks the end of week one and is rarely seen by fans. I'm hoping that this will bring it a little out of the shadows. This is The Terror of the Tongs, which takes Hammer on a slightly different direction. 1910 Hong Kong is our setting, with Captain Jackson's sail arriving to one of his passengers, Mr. Ming, being murdered. Captain Sale hears of a group called the Red Dragon Tong, who could have been the cause of the murder. Soon after the death of Mr. Ming, Captain Sale suffers another blow as his daughter Helena is murdered. He soon finds out that the Red Dragon Tong are behind it by them chopping off three of her fingers, which is their trademark when killing. Captain Sale is now up for revenge against the Tongs and won't let anyone stand in his way. This was directed by Anthony Bushell, who is not a Hammer usual, and you can tell straight away that this is directed by an outsider. Usually with Hammer films, we get opening credits and then the film starts. However, with this, we get an introduction before the credits, and I think this works really well as it sets the mood for the film and establishes the fear of the Red Dragon Tongs. Christopher Lee stars in this as Chung King, who is the leader of the Red Dragon Tongs. I personally feel this is Lee's weakest role out of the films I've reviewed so far. He plays his role well, but I feel this isn't his most memorable. Even though he's the star of the film, he's pretty much in the background and really doesn't do too much. However, this is the most convincing non-Chinese person at playing a Chinaman in the film. It is known that when Christopher Lee was on set, he would ask the Chinese people to help him not offend anyone with his portrayal of a Chinaman. The main problem I have with this is the lack of authentic Chinese people. We have way too many people doing dodgy Chinese accents. The dodgy accents made me feel a little uncomfortable when watching the film and threw me a bit out of the story. All in all, I wouldn't say this is Hammer's best work, and I will probably not go back to this film on a regular occasion. However, I do feel it's worth at least one watch, so do give it a try.